Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which HiveScoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. Let us understand how we can write queries in Impala. When it comes to syntax of the queries, it follows Hive syntax itself. But when it comes to running, it uses Impala D instead of MapReduce or Spark to run those queries. You have to launch Impala shell to just understand how to run Impala queries. You can say --- Impala D equal to one of the Impala D IP address or DNS alias along with the port number. In this case, it can be Big Data Server --5 or --6 or --7, and then colon 21,000. Now you should say show databases to list the databases. We have a RetailDB database. Let us open that database or connect to that database saying use retail_db, and then say show tables to list the tables. Now you can see that there is a table called as orders. Let us create one more table which is nothing but order items. So here I am creating another table order_items. The first field in this table is nothing but order item ID, which is of type int. The second field is order item order ID, which is also of type int. The third field is order item product ID, which is also of type int. The fourth one is order item. Let me come up with this again because there is a typo here. So I'm copy pasting this one. And then order_item product_ID int order item quantity int order item subtotal float, and then order item product price, which is also of type float. Then I can say row format delimited fields terminated by comma. Again, the data is in local file system under /data/retail_db or /home/itversity/data/retail_db. We have to load into HDFS location first, and then from there I have to move the data to this table. That being said, I can say shell Hadoop fs -put. The location of order items is nothing but home itversity data retail_db order_items. Here I'll be using -f so that it will replace if the directory already exists. Then I have to give the HDFS path, which is nothing but user itversity retail_db, and hit enter. Then I can say shell Hadoop fs -chmod -R777, then user itversity retail_db order items. And then I can copy this and say load data in path into table order_items and hit enter. Now the file is copied into this HDFS location to which this table is pointing to. We can validate by saying select *from order_items (limit 10) and hit enter. Now you can see the data, however, the precision is gone, but that is fine. I think it is just side effect of Impala. The actual data will not be having these additional decimals, so you can ignore it for now. Now let's say I want to compute the revenue on daily basis for complete or closed orders. So I can write a query by joining orders and order items, filter on complete or closed orders, and then group by order date, and then compute sum of order item subtotal to get the daily revenue. So here you can write the Hive query, which is nothing but select o.orderDate. So O will be the alias for orders, and then sum of oi.orderItemsSubtotal. So oi will be the alias for order items. Let's say revenue is the field name here, or alias for this expression sum of oi.orderItemsSubtotal. Then I can say from orders O join order_items oi on o.orderID equal to oi.orderItemOrderID, where o.orderStatus in complete comma closed group by o.orderDate, and then order by o.orderDate, and hit enter. Now you can see that the query ran successfully. So this is how you should be able to run the Hive query to get the solution as per your requirements. Here there are too many decimals. If you want, you can actually round these decimals to 2 by applying round function and then say (2) after sum, and then you should be good to go. So you can write any valid Hive query like this, and it should be able to execute using Impala daemon process in the background. And if you look at the logs that are generated here, the query submitted onto Big Data Server -5 using this port number. So this is the coordinator process which will actually take care of running the query by communicating with the other daemon process in the cluster. So depending upon the data volume, it will use several additional processes to run this query. If you want to track the progress of this query while it is running, you should be able to use this URL and you should be able to track. So this is how you should be able to run the query. It will use Impala D process that are part of the cluster to actually execute the query.